Rosalita, I found out you had been sleeping with my husband, Ricardo.
Consuela, that's crazy. You are my best friend.
Oh, yeah? Oh, yeah? I saw the two of you climbing into the back of Mr. Gonzalez Flabé.
It only happened once. It was the night that you went out to buy more yarn for your Julio Iglesias poncho.
This is a nice poncho.
You whore! No, it will never, ever happen again, I swear!
Honey, we're out of alphabets.
Ricardo!
I can't explain.
No.
We interrupt this program to bring you this special news update.
Troubled young actors Robert Downey Jr. and Christian Slater have announced plans to star in a remake of the beloved Western film A Fistful of Dollars. The movie, tentatively called A Fistful of Crack, will begin shooting in 6 months, three with good behavior. That's all the news for now. We now return you to your regularly scheduled program.
You said, take the RuPaul show. It's on VH1. Ooh, it's big for you. Well, it's not big, and he's a bitch, and you better take care of it, because you want to know what? You better got some money for me, because he sure as hell don't.
We are tired of being treated like pieces of meat. Leave us at once.
Spock, analysis.
The erection sounds serious, Captain. We must be prepared for anything. They could take over the ship, or attack us from the rear.
Spock, you Vulcan pervert, I said on deck.
Sorry, sir, can't control myself.
This is Captain Rue T. Kirk. We're on a peace mission. Why do you attack us?
You and your crew will pay for what you've done, Kirk.
Captain, the ship has sustained heavy damage. We've lost warp drive.
Any contact with the planet surface?
Yes, sir. They say they're coming aboard to pay us back. What does that mean, sir?
Well, Spock, they could torture us for hours in many different positions with many scented oils.
Will they probe us?
Most certainly, Spock.
Surrender! It's time for payback.
Well, come on, girl! You better get your green Vulcan ass up. We got some payback to get. Woo! Party! Come on. Woo!
Oh. Do you see that?
See what? Oh, my God, that man-eating shark about to devour those three children?
No, duh. That really cute guy with that humongous package. What?
Oh, my God, honey. It looks like he's in trouble.
I know. I saw him first.
No, honey, get out of my way because I am head lifeguard,
okay? I
don't think
so.
I will cut you, Rhonda.
Let's get you, big skank.
Crazy skanks?
No.
Fine!
Please.
Get down here.
Okay. Okay, it's obvious that he is delirious, and yeah. I think I'm gonna have to give him mouth to mouth.
Get the hell? Mouth to mouth? No, look. He has got water in his lungs. I must massage his pecs.
Okay.
No,
he has hypothermia. I must cover him with my body for body heat.
Oh. Got your Christmas present from Rue.
From Rue? Why can't he bring it?
Pedicure.
Ugh, give me a break. Wonder what he got this year, big old master spender. You're kidding. A RuPaul t-shirt? What a cheap pig. And that doesn't even look like him. It's a picture of me.
What do you call a relationship?
relationship when your boyfriend only wants to make out to Billy Ray Cyrus?
An achy, breaky, mistakey. Hi, Michelle.
Yeah?
Did you put the cat out?
Why? Was it on fire?
Hi, Michelle. Have you seen my saddle and chaps?
Will, I told you I have a date tonight.
Are you tired of all those other psychic hotlines that claim to know your past and your future?
Uh-huh.
Well, if you really want somebody to look into your future, then look no further. Here at the Psychic Skeezer Network, we tell you the entire truth about your future, whether you like it or not. You ready for your psychic reading?
Yeah.
Okay. Let's see here. The cards say that, you're a dirty slut.
Wow, that is so true.
Oh, this here. Hygiene is not very important to you, is it?
No, not at all.
In the future, I see you at happy hour at Houlihan's, where you meet a man. Oh. Actually, make that several men. In a stall in the men's room. Then I see you a few weeks later on antibiotics.
My personal psychic reading was so amazing, it was like she was in the stall with me. Us. All of us. Ow.
So don't wait. Call the Psychic Skeezer Network now.
You'll be glad you did.
Listen to this, Mr. Agent. Now on top of this, he wants me to be stripper in the next show. Mm-hmm. Mm. You know, it's so out of character for me, and I'm not doing it.
In a world gripped with fear and crime, a ruthless cosmetics queen holds a city hostage, and only one woman can free her town from oppression.
You looking for an ass-whooping sucker?
RuPaul is star booty in Take That, You Honky Bitch. Also starring Golden Globe nominee Michelle Visage as La Cienega, the Ice Princess. Roger Ebert of the Chicago Tribune says, there's so much action, I nearly cracked my pants. This summer, if you're white, you're dead. Rated NC-17. No crackers under 17 admitted.
Ooh, Lordy, honey, my feet is hurting and stuff. I'm over. No, you come over here, baby.
Come
what
here,
you got
Poppy.
About? Come here. Oh, my.
You know who I saw yesterday?
Who?
Mariah Carey, honey.
You're kidding, Miss Mariah.
I swear. And I wore this shirt today in tribute to her.
Oh, that's like the video Sunday.
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 Hey. Sunday.
Hey.
Sunday. Sunday. Come on, bring it on.
Hey. Me and Mariah. Go back like baby, we'll pass the fire. Whoa. Hey, Daddy, come here. You got some money for me?
Money. Give me some money. Oh. See, this cost a lot of money, honey.
Oh, baby.
Bring it on. You got some money for me and Papa.
Bring the money, bring the noise.
Come on, honey.
So tell me, Ru, what actually inspired you to do this Christmas special? Great idea.
Well, Cindy, I believe Christmas is about children. I really do. And I believe that children are our future. Teach them well and let them lead the way.
Please!
Michelle Visage, why can't you give me the respect I can get from any second banana?
Because I'm not one of your fans!
Michelle, go to your dressing room. Go to your dressing room and don't come out until you learn to apologize! Now, Cindy, this isn't gonna affect my cover story, is it?